I came to Planned Parenthood seeking women's healthcare services.
I came to Planned Parenthood for birth control.
They made a priority to make sure that I knew all of the information and that I felt comfortable.
Because the atmosphere here is one of acceptance and understanding and health.
Why would I go anywhere else?
We are Planned Parenthood Southwest Ohio, the region's most trusted reproductive health care provider. Go to ppswo.org to find the health center nearest you.
Blog Talk Radio.
What you are about to hear are the views of Travis Pope and the Oklahoma Tomcat and is not supported by the government. Agreeing with the hosts of this show could cause you to be targeted by the government and government agencies. You have been warned.
Welcome, Political TNT. This is a pre-recorded show, so no one can phone in or anything like that on this show. I thought that startup music was supposed to start by itself. I had it set up to start by itself. I didn't know you had to actually press that button.
it only started two shows ago.
Yeah, it's supposed to start by itself.
Yeah, I'll have to take a look at the settings again. Maybe our studio, maybe the computers took over and said, "Hey, this shouldn't be starting up by itself. It's offensive to the to my gods."
Oh yeah.
We can't tell people that any messages are against them.
So Joseph, so the Oklahoma Tomcat sent everybody a last minute message last night to do a show today.
I could be up eating breakfast this morning. I'm over there in California, so everybody is 2 hours ahead of me.
He's 3 hours over there in New York, and it's still 7 o'clock, and I don't want to be up this morning.
Hey, no matter where you are, you are supposed to always be on true time, which is Tulsa time.
Whatever.
What happened to you're dedicated to the show? You're dedicated to the show.
Well, we are dedicated to the show. Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday. what really is going on is Joseph misses us so much. He's trying to expand to more days now.
Yeah. The show should be on every single day because, you know, it's a great show because I'm great and that makes this show great. I'm glad you guys are so dedicated.
I'm glad he doesn't have the controls as well. Blow him off.
Hey, you're not supposed to be at the controls.
Y'all like the she likes that blowing up stuff too much now.
I know, man. What's happening to my little sister?
That's what she don't have a problem blowing you up since you took the lovely away from her.
So, I bet she wishes she had it at work, huh?
Yes, I do.
So to continue with a little bit of our conversation on Wednesday, I've been having I went into a one of them deplorable groups. You know, the Trump bot groups.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And I posted in there. They added me a long time ago, but I've never posted in it, so I made my first post in it yesterday. And I said, what was it? I said, y'all remember that nice tax cut we got? Trump is proposing or open to a 25-cent increase on gas tax. And that created a guano storm amongst the deplorables. And as usual, the status is going to state that they're okay with the 25-cent gas tax increase because their God said so.
Yep. Yep, and the one-year post, I think it was on Heated Disagreement, I made that comment. I was like, I bet the Republicans are going to justify this.
Yeah, they justify it because it's a use tax, what they're saying. It's a use tax, and it's dedicated strictly for infrastructure. And then I went after them with this. I said, what about all the taxes for infrastructure that we had been paying for the years that they've never done anything with the roads? And one of them said, well, the roads are so bad now that they need to increase the taxes on it to get them repaired. And I'm like, how is that my problem? I've been paying, so I now have to pay more?
Yeah, That makes no sense at all because, like you stated, we have been paying into it. Why are they in the condition they're in? It's like when Mary Fallon posted on Facebook quite a while back. She was bragging about how much infrastructure repair, how many projects we've completed on infrastructures and stuff. You know, she was giving numbers. Numbers on the bridges, the number of roads that's been repaired and all this stuff. And I commented back, I was like, you mean we had that many bad roads and bridges in Oklahoma? Why haven't they been fixed earlier? You know? If we're paying into this stuff, we should be having the repairs done as they're needed. We shouldn't be waiting until 99% of America, which Travis and I are constantly going. I mean, how many road constructions are we going through every single day now? And it's all year round. It used to be, when I first started driving, it used to be you had what was called construction season, all right? And that was the time of year when roads were getting their maintenance done and all that stuff. And that was okay because, you know, you have to do it. You know, as long as it's being kept up. Now it's all year long, miles upon miles upon miles of construction. We are in construction zones more than we are out of them. That's how bad it is.
Yeah, and look at Houston, Texas. I live in Houston. Look at Houston. Houston has been under construction for the last 15 years. I've lived there for 15 years. And when I first entered into construction for the first time in my life, it was 15 years ago, and it was under construction, and they do it and the way they have it set up, they'll start on one end of Houston, and they'll move all the way over to the other end, and then they start back over on the other end that they started on. They redo it. I'm like, they never stop. You know, you can't make it through Houston without going through construction zones.
You know, you can't.
And Fort Worth, they finally started doing their construction a few years ago. They needed, especially right there at the I-35 and I-35 right before you enter into Houston right there on the loop. It was real bad right there. But now it's even worse. I mean, you try to go through that area, you're stuck there for about 3 hours.
Yeah.
You know. But that was a needed spot, though. I understand that spot, and that's the only area in Fort Worth that I've seen construction. But, you know, back to the point is that we've been paying taxes. I mean, we're commercial truck drivers. You know, I noticed the other day when I was in Indiana or Illinois, I think it's Illinois. That now next time you're through there, look at your receipt. They have a sugar tax.
Oh yeah. In fact, I think New York has one too. I think they have a sugar tax too. I think I remember Edith complaining about it one time. at least I think it was. I think it was our not so lovely but smart producer that said that.
Because it's a lame tax.
Yeah, I call those sin taxes. They're taxes like cigarette taxes, sugar tax. In fact, there's a federal sugar tax too. It's actually import tax on sugar to try to get people to drink more high fructose corn syrup rather than sugar. You know, which of course is worse for you. You know, so our federal government wants us to drink more of it.
I call it the fat bastard tax.
You're not saying that too loud. You know, the state of gods might be listening. They might implement a fat tax. In fact, I think Germany has that. Yeah, it's amazing. You know, the Republican Party, I used to be a Republican back when I was ignorant, you know, and now I'm a lot smarter and wiser. But they've always preached that they're against the taxes, you know. But it seems like they're becoming more and more and more and more progressive. I think, Travis, do you remember when I made the posted on Facebook that the one thing I liked about Obama was that he was showing just how progressive the Democrats are?
Yeah.
Well, now I'm gonna have to post another one saying the one thing I like about Trump is he's showing how progressive Republicans are.
Yeah. Oh. Speaking of progressive, you hear what Trump said yesterday?
No, I didn't.
No, you didn't.
No. I've been neglecting my job of keeping up on the news in the last few days.
Let's see. See if I can find that link. He told Congress to get on it on gun control.
Oh yeah, well I didn't hear that particular thing, but yeah, I have been hearing that Trump. In fact, I've been posting about it on various groups that Trump is. I knew this when he was running, that he was for gun control. So that's not shocking one bit. But yeah, no, I didn't hear that he actually told Congress to get together on it. Oh man.
Yeah. Here's my post about it. I said, "Your God has spoken. Now get in line and worship." Trump urges Congress to take action on guns.
That's a good post. I like it.
It says, here it is. President throws weight behind bill to expand background checks, dashes conservative hopes on expanding concealed carry. Washington. President Donald Trump backed a Senate proposal to expand background checks on gun sales Wednesday as part of a call for a sweeping overhaul of U.S. gun policy in the wake of the Florida school shooting. In a meeting with lawmakers at the White House, Mr. Trump also dashed conservative hopes that he would support a move now for gun owners to legally carry concealed firearms in one state, to carry them in the other 49 states, a long-sought goal of the National Rifle Association. By the way, I have canceled my NRA membership, and he bucked Republican orthodoxy by suggesting the swift removal of guns from people who are potentially mentally ill. As he continued to seek legislative response to the deaths of 17 people in Parkland, Florida High School 2 weeks ago, Mr. Trump's comments came on the same day Walmart Inc. and Dick's Sporting Goods Inc. said they were no longer sell guns to anyone under 21 years old, as two of the country's biggest gun sellers tightened their policies in the wake of the shooting. So, he basically spit on his voters with the gun control. With the gun control, sweeping background checks, and now that's what it's looking like, that we're ended up
yeah.
gonna get sweeping back, expanding background checks. He squashed their idea about being able to carry in all 49 states, which basically I'm against that too, because that's not what the
yeah.
Constitution was about. But
you're right.
But it's funny watching how Trump is actually going against his base now. That's my point about the whole thing.
And you know, I'm going to be watching real closely, because I've always been curious, because I mean the Republicans that support Trump were supporting Trump just like the Democrats that supported Obama. No matter what Obama did, they were for it, even if it went against what they've been against before, you know. And I'm curious to see just how loyal this base is. You know, will they now justify this gun control? And you have to keep us updated. I'm assuming you posted that to your local group, right?
I posted that in the deplorable group, you know, all the
okay.
Trump bots.
Yeah, okay. Keep us updated on the responses to that, because I'm curious of how loyal they are. But here's the thing with that thing, that there is a bill currently in Congress. I wasn't expecting to do this, talk about this today, but otherwise I would have uploaded the audio. There is a bill that is in Congress. This bill's been presented many, many, many times. And what the bill does makes it to where there is a background check, a tougher background check. There's an exemption in this background check. If you know the person, you will be able to sell to them without going through the background check. Well, here you go, okay? This great loophole that's in the that they complain about in the gun sales. Somebody goes into those gun shows, and they want to buy a gun, and the seller says, well, I'll have to charge you for the background check. I'll have to, you know, do this background check, which will take, you know, several days But I'll tell you what. Here's my card. Give me a call, and I'll sell it to you as a friend. And that's the thing. These are false security that they're asking for. They are not going to protect us. Okay? Because there's always a way around it. And here's the other thing, you know. The 21, I posted videos on, I think on my personal page and on groups. Heated Disagreement was one of them. Of a 19-year-old mom who used a gun to protect her and a rifle to protect her and her baby. You can't sell a gun to a 21-year-old. This mom would have, there's two intruders breaking into her house. This was on news. Two intruders were breaking her house. Why do Democrats want her to get killed, her and her baby to get killed and possibly raped?
Yeah.
Because that's what's been, you know, they talk about these universities and colleges being such rape grounds and everything, right? I mean, this is their own words, not mine. I mean, all these Democrats, all these liberals that go to college, they're raping everyone, right? Raping all these females. And we know that this is fact, people. You cannot dispute it. This is science, okay, of the human body. Females, pound for pound, females have less strength than men. All right? They don't have the upper body strength. Females, there are a lot of females who depend on guns, especially young ones, because let's face it, they're the ones that are most targeted, right? They depend on these guns because they cannot fight off an intruder. And no, to the Democrat congresswomen and men in office, peeing on your attacker is not going to work. It'll probably get killed. Okay? That is a stupid suggestion I've ever heard. Yelling. Sorry, if the guy speaks up on you, you're not going to have a chance to yell, all right? He's going to make sure you're silent. Pepper spray. I watch this self-defense guy on YouTube quite often. Many times I'll post his videos. And pepper sprays don't always work either, all right? They're not 100% effective, and the attacker has to be, well, pretty close to you. Yeah. And then let's talk about knives, you know. I mean, we don't talk a lot about defense against knives and stuff. There, a lot of people cannot defend themselves against a knife attack unless they have a gun. And there was a news article not too long ago where that actually did happen, where there was a knife attack, and luckily both guys survived because the other guy had a gun, had an AR-15, and all he had to do was pull that AR-15 out, and the guy with the knife knew better than to, try to attack him any further. He did get one strike with the knife in before the guy pulled out the AR-15, grabbed the AR-15. But, I mean, this is fact, people. Not everyone can defend themselves physically, okay? And then if your attacker has a weapon, defending yourself with your bare hands, it just ain't going to work. But, yeah, no. Trump is a statist. You guys worshiping him?
Well, like I said, I didn't vote for Trump because I knew what he was.
Yep. Yeah, both of us were warning people.
And it was just a matter of time his colors come through instead of him doing liberal ideas.
Mm-hmm.
He was trying to basically do the ideas of his base.
Yes.
And and like
like a rabid dog, he turned on him.
Yep. And tell you the truth, I am a little bit shocked because I was stating before that, you know, he's going to play on the being a conservative type, being conservative up until the midterms, and then once Democrats take office, then he's going to start showing, especially after the re-election, you know, he's re-elected, then he was going to start showing his progressiveness. But so I am a little bit shocked. I didn't expect that he was going to do this so soon, you know. I guess he feels so self-confident that his base is going to stick with him no matter what, that he's such a great great person, a great speaker, and a great, you know, that everything he does is great and everybody will love his greatness, that he thought he was going to be able to, that he thinks he'll get reelected even though he's a progressive. But then again, why shouldn't he? He's not the first progressive, he's the most progressive Republican we've had as far as in my time, but he's not the first. Bush got reelected. Bush was a progressive.
Yeah.
So actually he does, you know, he does have a chance. Just Trump is Trump is the Obama of the Republican Party.
Yeah.
Cuz he's he stepped up the game with the, you know, his progressiveness. I mean, he's really pushing the envelope with the Republicans, see how far he can go. And Obama did that with the Democrats. Because before Obama, Democrats were at least somewhat, you know, sane.
I wouldn't call them sane, but...
Well, they were more, you know, let's face it, they did call out a lot of things with that Bush was doing. You know, I mean, they did call out a lot of stuff, and, you know, at least we were able to watch them while Republican was in office to see what that Republican was doing. We can't even do that now because they've gone so far, Quano, that we can't even depend on them to watch Trump. But yeah, I'm wanting to see that exactly what the Republicans do.
Well, when I posted that, and I said that, you know, I read what I said on here, and I told them to bow down to their and worship their God. One guy said he only has one God, and it's not Trump. And I was like, well, but that he was the only one that made a comment on it.
Yeah, I get that a lot. And in fact, I had one girl ask me why I keep on calling the federal government her gods. And I said, I was like, well, if you have faith, and if you have lots of faith, and what they do, you know, with protecting you and everything to be your saviors, then they're your gods. So, oh. and one day I'll have to do a show. We'll have to do a show on that. You know, why we call the federal government the state of gods. You know, I started doing this quite a while back with. Calling them the gods. That's because, you know, the way I look at things, and I won't get into it a whole lot here, but just to touch on it. So look at things. If you have faith, that means you believe even though you cannot see, you know, the actions or, you know, there's no physical proof in that belief. But you believe it with all your heart. You're not budging on it. And if you do that, if you look at anything or anyone with that much faith, they are a god to you. You've made them a god. You know, and then there's only, and for us Christians, we believe there's only one, for lack of better words, person, spirit or whatever, that we're supposed to have that much faith in, and that's God, you know, that's our Father. So, you know, that's the whole reason why I get into the whole statism is a religious belief. But it's time for us to take a break, so we'll go ahead and take our break. For this show here, what we're going to do is we're going to go over the Libertarian platform, and we're going to go through the whole list of the Libertarian platform, and then we're going to focus for this show on personal liberty. We'll be right back. And you say this, make sure you're praying to Trump. Listen to him.
A boy born in Joplin, Missouri was fascinated by anything with wheels and a motor. The odds of him going on to fascinate millions with his talent? 1 in 260,000. The odds of this born racer having 157 career top 10 finishes in NASCAR? 1 in 125 billion. But every driver seeks the pinnacle of their achievements. The odds of him winning both the Daytona 500 and the Brickyard 400 in the same year? 1 in 195 million. The odds of a child being diagnosed with autism? 1 in 68. I'm NASCAR driver Jamie McMurray, and my niece has autism. Learn more at autismspeaks.org/signs. Early diagnosis can make a lifetime of difference. Brought to you by Autism Speaks and the Ad Council.
You may have doubts about healthcare sharing. I know we did. We studied literature about Samaritan Ministries, but we feared that it was just too risky. Instead, as our health insurance premiums went up each year, we would increase our deductible to reduce the premium. And then the inevitable happened. We had to use our insurance. We had a medical need that included tests, doctor visits, and even outpatient surgery treatment that totaled over $7,000. And it was all out of pocket. It took us 3 years to pay off, even after several of our health care providers reduced their charges. And we finally took a leap of faith and joined Samaritan.
Each month, we get to give to an actual person with a medical need. We pray for them and put them in the hands of the Lord for physical, emotional, and financial strength and healing. There's no way to fully express that pleasure and joy. During the first year we were members, we had a medical need, and it was all provided for, and the strength, peace, and healing from prayer.
Last year, our son was injured on a mission trip 1,200 miles from home. The bills for the emergency room, doctors, stitches, and prescriptions totaled $5,300. But every last cent was provided for. In fact, last year we had two more needs, and each time our Samaritan family came through.
I worked in healthcare for 10 years, from front desk through billing. I would recommend Samaritan instead of any insurance product out there. Insurance has no assurances. In fact, it seems everything is written in such a way that there will be no assurance at your time of need. We just wish that we had trusted in God's provision sooner.
It is such a blessing to come alongside our brothers and sisters in Christ and share in each other's healthcare burdens. And there's such a peace and joy knowing that God is answering our prayers, bringing healing and providing for our needs.
Now we return to Political TNT with Travis Pope and the Oklahoma Tomcat. If you want to join in the conversation, dial 914-338-1906 and our lovely producer will get you on our show.
All right. yeah, the studio messed up on me. Yeah. back. Like I said, we're going to go through the Libertarian platform, and I won't do this year because of the this year it's we're headed into an election, the midterm elections. I know that not as many people vote in those midterm elections. I beg people to please get involved in the midterm elections. This actually it's funny because the midterm elections should be more important than the actual elections because of the fact that it does involve more of the local government, and the local government does have more effect on effect in our everyday life than the national government. At least that's the way it's supposed to be. The federal government's not supposed to be so much involved in our everyday life. But I really wanted to promote the Libertarian Party, get our word out there, because I do believe that a lot of people are libertarians, just don't realize it. You know, I believe that the majority of people really do want government out of their personal life. You know, the trick is to make it get people to see that. If you give the government the power to take away other people's rights so that you can have more freedom, then you're giving the government the right to take your rights away too. If the government has that much power, they're going to take away your rights. They are involved in your everyday life. Let's go on down this list. As libertarians, we seek a world of liberty, a world in which all individuals are sovereign over their own lives, and no one is forced to sacrifice his or her values for the benefit of others. That's true. Libertarian Party is really the only party that actually looks at each person as a sovereign person, and that what that means is that you have control over your own life. The government doesn't. The first thing is personal liberty. The Libertarian Party is the only party that is for true liberty, true freedom, and personal freedom. Individuals are free to make any choice they want for themselves and must also accept personal responsibility. Unfortunately, a lot of times the federal government, in the attempt to take away anything bad that can happen because you made a bad choice, by doing that, they're taking away your freedom. And we just talked about the sugar tax, you know, the fact that the government taxes sugar because, or in some areas because of the fact that they feel that, well, sugar's bad for you, and therefore we must protect you from yourself, and therefore we must tax it and put a sin tax on it. By putting a sin tax on it, you know, then you're okay to eat sugar. Sounds like a religion, you know. Let's go ahead and punish you for your sin, you know, with statism. That punishment is you must pay for your sin. And both Republicans and Democrats are bad for this, with that for the personal liberty. The other thing is economic liberty. The Libertarian Party is for complete freedom in spending your money any way you feel fit. All right. Libertarians want people to have abundant opportunities to achieve economic success. You can start any business you want as long as that business now does not take away other people's right to life, liberty, and a pursuit of happiness, meaning slavery would not be a business that us libertarians would be for. Hitman is not a business we would be for, because now you're taking away other people's right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. If the business does not physically harm other people or economically harm other people, we are completely for it. Yes, we are for prostitution. Okay, now that doesn't mean us personally are for it, because I am against it personally, okay, because prostitution, you know, it does hurt yourself, you know, and therefore I am against it, you know. But as far as the politically, I say, why shouldn't the government allow it? All right, I mean, if the person wants to put themselves in that position, and as long as they're not physically harming other people, go for it. Okay, now I'm not going to go to that business, you know, but I am for the freedom of people to do it, you know. Securing liberty, that's another thing that libertarians are for. Now, and what the libertarians believe is there's one job that the government has, the only one proper purpose of government, and that is to protect life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. All right. So we are for law enforcement. We are for laws that prevent you or prevent your neighbor from harming you. All right. And what by harming, I don't mean hurting your feelings, all right? By harming, I don't mean, you know, opening up a business and saying certain people cannot go to that business. That's not harming, okay? You got the freedom to go to their competitor, all right? Or start your own business that caters to what they won't, the people they won't cater to. But as far as, you know, protecting you from somebody shooting you, somebody stealing your property, somebody harming your property, your family, or anything like that, we are for, you know, the government stepping in and doing that. As far as securing, I'm sorry. I got my papers all mixed up here. Securing liberty, okay. The other one is crime and justice. This kind of goes with securing liberty also. I'm sorry, I'm mixing it up. That there's going back to the other one. Securing liberty is the last thing I have here. No, it ain't. I'm sorry. freedom of expression and communication. Libertarians are completely for, you know, you being able to say whatever you want, all right, and also expressing whatever you want, again, as long as you do not do physical harm to other people or their property, or, you know, preventing them from being able to enjoy life. For instance, you know, why I add that in there is because, you know, these protests where they're actually destroying people's property and physically hurting people, that's no. That is not what the First Amendment was meant to be for. All right. Peaceful protest, yes. Being able to speak out against government, yes. We are completely for all that. The other thing is privacy. We are the only political party that is for complete privacy. Both with Bush and with Obama, and now even with Trump, we do see that both the Republicans and Democrats are for government spying on you and government abusing the courts in order to get warrants. Both
all right,
Republicans
I'm back.
And all right, welcome back. I'm going down the list of the libertarian platform. I'm on privacy right now, and as I was saying, the Libertarian Party is the only party that is for complete privacy. And this, we're completely for the Fourth Amendment. Both Democrats and Republicans have demonstrated that both of them are okay with spying. They're okay with abusing the courts to get search warrants. They're both okay with vehicles being stopped and searched. And this also includes third parties, you know, information you have with third parties. So we're against emails being looked at. We're against phone calls being monitored. We're against the government right now probably listening in on this.
Well, we're on a radio show, so they probably
That is free. For instance, Travis and my morning meetings. You know, they're probably listening in on that. we're against all that. They should not be spying on us in any way, shape, or form, except what we do post on social media and, you know, where it's already out there. It's like this radio show, for instance. That's okay. personal relationships. Now, I'm going to reemphasize what I said earlier. You know, just because we're for things as far as politically goes, as far as socially goes, does not mean we support those actions, okay? And I'm emphasizing that with this because there are personal relationships that I am personally against. But that doesn't mean that government should step in and license it and regulate it and say what is okay and what isn't in personal relationships. The Libertarian Party is completely for you being in any relationship you want, as long as it's consensual. That, you know, as long as it's two people, three people, four people, five people, 10 people, okay with a relationship, hey, go at it, you know. Just don't expect me to endorse it.
Also, I would like to say, too, end of age.
Well, that's part of the consensual.
There's a few people in our party that have taken that lead to mean the wrong thing, and basically they are making the liberty, because they're loudmouths and they're making the party look bad. And the fact that they're okay with and these are a few, and trust me, we are keeping an eye on them too. But these are the guys that think it's okay to have relationships with minors, which the Libertarian Party is against. Just for the show's for everybody to know, I'm a county chairman of my county of the Libertarian Party. So I actually hold an office in the Libertarian Party. So, and the consensus of the leadership is we do not agree with relations with minors or anything like that. That is against that, because we don't feel that the children or minors have the ability to make that consent without coercion. And
right.
most of the time within stuff like that, a child is coerced into thinking that they love someone when they really don't. Because they're easily influenced. But with that being said, if you see somebody that claims to be libertarian that is for that type of nonsense, they're not libertarian, write them off as stupid and walk away from them.
I'm glad you brought that up, because
the Libertarian Party as a whole and the platform do not agree and do not support sexual relations with minors.
Right. And now I'm glad you brought that up, because I have had that debate on Facebook before with people who think that the Libertarian Party, by saying we're open for any relationship and we're against licensing of relationships, that meant that minor. So age of consent laws would still be in effect. That is where we go back to point number three I made earlier with securing liberty and with the law enforcement and stuff like that. Local government is to make laws that protect life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. Age of consent laws are part of that in protecting innocent people who are not able to make decisions, who don't have, you know, the wisdom. And the age of consent laws are to be local, not federal. It's up to the local people in that area to decide, you know, who they consider to be an adult. So I'm glad you did emphasize the age of consent. But, you know, as long as the two people can consent legally, and not just legally, but also we do have to add one more thing. You know, how about people who, because of mental disorders or whatever, cannot consent? You know, that's the same thing. So, you know, as long as the two people can consent to a relationship, whatever that relationship is, we're not just talking about, marriage and sexual and stuff like that. But as long as those two people can consent to the relationship, hey, go at it.
That's the area on that too. Is that, you know, there's a lot of in any party that they're in, and this goes for any of the parties, because we've seen a lot of arrests and outing political figures in the Democrats and the Republican base of their actions with minors as well. So don't sit there and say, well, the Libertarian Party is for this, and they have these type of people in their party. We don't want to be no part of it. Well, you know what? All I have to do is say, Anthony Weiner. Anthony Weiner. Sending inappropriate pictures to minors, okay?
Yeah.
There's your Democrat base. And then what was that judge that was judge, I can't remember his name, that was in what was it, Alabama or something like that, that had relations with minors as well, that lost
yeah.
the election. So it's not just a one party infestation. We have all
no.
these people in all these parties. So
and that goes to human, you know, the fact that there's bad people everywhere, in every group, in every organization, everywhere. So I mean, there's bad people, and you got people also that's out to make other people look bad or other groups look bad. Going down the list here.
The Libertarian Party. If you don't count up the Libertarian Party, these knuckleheads believe. Then you need to count off all the parties for what the other knuckleheads actually done.
Yeah, yep. The other thing is abortion. Now, we're going to go in detail on these in other episodes of these pre-recorded shows that we do. But just to hit on it, the Libertarian Party, they believe government should be out of abortion. Totally, and it should be left to the individual. It doesn't mean that the individuals in the Libertarian Party are for or against abortion. It's just where the party stands, that government should not be involved, should not promote, should not forbid, should not abortion at all. I have my other things that take a lot of time. We're just going down this list on this half hour, and then we're going to get to personal liberty.
Abortion is basically a 10th Amendment issue anyway. That should be left
yes,
to the
states. Yeah, that's where you and I stand. The Libertarian Party does stand differently on it as far as their platform goes. They believe government, no matter what at what level, should be out of abortion. But we'll get into more detail on that one, because that one there, it does, will involve a lot of time. When we get on a show where we talk about abortion, we'll talk more on that one. But as far as Libertarian Party goes, just to put it out there for everyone, they believe that the government should be out of it, that it should be left to individuals. If you don't like abortion, then you don't have to have it. Plus, you don't have to pay for it. Now, that's where I'm like, okay, good. You know, that's correct. Currently, believe it or not, you can play the numbers any tricky way you want to play it. We do pay for abortion currently, whether you are for or against it, and that there is wrong. Parental rights. As long as the child's not being abused, the Libertarian Party is 100% for parents to raise their child in any way they feel fit. Government should not be telling you how to raise your kid. The only time the government should step in again is... Yeah, go ahead.
That means if you don't want to do vaccinations, you don't have to have special cause to get the vaccination. Let's say your religion doesn't believe in vaccinations, okay?
Right.
Well, you don't have to prove that. You're not being forced to do, you know. As it currently is, you have to prove why you don't want your kid to have vaccinations.
Right, in some states, Oklahoma does have parental right laws, which we don't vaccinate, and we don't have to show why we don't.
Yeah. Well, you remember a while back that we had all those controversies about kids not receiving medicines and stuff that would help them, or parents not going to the doctor because a kid is sick, or they're not receiving blood transfusions because of their faith and all that stuff.
Yeah.
You remember all that stuff, and then they went after the parents, you know?
Yeah.
That's a lot in the parental rights. You might think, well, I don't like that. Well, you know what? We don't like the foot of the government on our necks either. If it ain't actual physical abuse, and the way our system is going now, they're labeling anything as abuse.
Yeah.
You make your kid, the United Nations even tried to push it where if you make your kids do homework and chores, then it's abuse. A few years ago, the Department of Labor passed a rule that if your kid worked on your farm, then that was considered child labor. That was abuse because you were going against child labor laws. Which that backfired on them, and they had to back out of it. But they still,
thankfully they did. Yeah, thankfully they did.
And the thing is, though, as a lot of people don't realize, you know, now in a few more years, they'll actually try that rule again, and it'll actually pass and it'll actually stick. Because of the fact is that they're slowly brainwashing our children in the schools to follow these ways.
Yeah. Yep. And to go through a few more of these before we go on our break. We only got a few minutes. Crime and justice. The Libertarian Party believes that the only role, proper role of government, is to protect life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Government should not be making people who are not harming other people criminals. The death penalty, the Libertarian Party is 100% against the death penalty. Self-defense, the Libertarian Party is for you to be able to defend yourself in any way possible. This is actually the only time that force can be used on other people is in self-defense. And the Libertarian Party is for you to be able to carry any weapon and own any weapon to be able to defend your life, liberty, and your pursuit of happiness. The government, they are against licensing any type of weapons. They are against any regulation that restricts the ownership of any type of weapons for you to use.
Again, that is the weapons. Me, I'm a constitutionalist. I am not what they call them incorporation doctrine.
Right.
I believe that the regulations of firearms fall on state and really local municipalities. Because if you look at some of the old times in the Old West, and read some of the stories of the Old West, many of those towns, you had to turn your firearms in to the sheriff when you entered that town. And you got them back when you left.
Yep. Yeah, and like I said, we'll go through each one of these for during each show that we do, pre-recorded shows we do. There are things that we as individuals do not totally agree with the Libertarian Party, but we'll discuss them and why we are libertarians, even though there are certain things in here that we may not. We're kind of like, you know, local government does have that right, and we do believe they can do that. But when we return, we're going to go over the number one that I mentioned, which was personal liberty. We'll go over that in more detail when we return. Hey, producer, I need you to take over the studio.
Okay.
In today's edition, we have two different stories that involve the incredible power of our Western icon, the cowboy's best friend.
Get ready to cowboy up, y'all. Time to ride. For New Mexico combat veterans that have been injured or are dealing with combat trauma, their battles don't stop when they come home. That's why the Express UU Bar Ranch, headquartered in Rayado, New Mexico, is joining a unique and special nonprofit program called Horses for Heroes. Started in 2007 by Special Forces veteran and cowboy Rick Iannucci of Santa Fe, the Horses for Heroes program uses horsemanship, the calming beauty of the ranch, and the cowboy way of life as a means to decompress the vet in a soothing and calming atmosphere. From there, the new program's goal is to breed a whole new brand of cowboy or cowgirl, as the vets learn how to become a top hand or a wrangler using the brotherhood mentality learned in combat.
The desire for the Express organization, our principal desire, is just to be able to open this ranch to that kind of activity. Let these people come enjoy the backcountry, get out of not being qualified or stuck into just riding around in a big pen, but instead getting out and just becoming part of nature, being able to enjoy that experience from the back of a horse. Winston Churchill once said is that the outside of a horse does wonders for the inside of a person.
It's Thursday night, and you're grabbing drinks with some friends. Started off with a pitcher for the table, which quickly becomes two. There's pool. And there's the photo booth.
All right, everybody squeeze in. Say cheese!
Followed naturally by an order of wings. And another.
Can we get some extra ranch sauce?
Then there's the ceremonial nightcap.
So what are we doing this weekend?
And lastly, it's back to the car, which, if you're buzzed, could be the most expensive night of your life. Getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Hi, I'm Joy, a student at Hillsdale College. Here is President of Hillsdale College, Dr. Larry Arn, on why the Constitution limits government.
James Madison writes in Federalist 51 that men are not angels. Their passions and self-interest often get the better of their reason and sense of justice. So we need government in order to protect our rights against those who would take them away. But for the same reason, Madison writes, government must be limited, because people in government have passions and interests too. Many Americans today forget this. Supposing that we can do away with constitutional limits on government, supposing that the unelected bureaucrats being put in charge of our health care, for example, will rule as if they are angels. If Madison was correct about human nature, this is foolish and dangerous.
This Constitution Minute was brought to you by Hillsdale College. To receive a free pocket constitution and declaration, go to constitutionminute.com.
Got your million bucks, you got your flashy sports car, you got your trophy girls, man, you think you're a star. You got your teeth bleached, you like to play the rich game, yeah, you think you're a cowboy, the new Jesse James. But I could kick your ass, I could jack your jaw, put you flat in the dirt, boy, yeah, I'd have a ball. But go ahead and act tough, like your John Wayne song, but things can change fast.
Now we return to Political TNT with Travis Pope and the Oklahoma Tomcat. If you want to join in the conversation, dial 914-338-1906 and our lovely producer will get you on our show.
All right, welcome back. Some that they say that the Libertarian Party does say in their platform is that anything they do not mention doesn't mean they condone or are against that situation. Of course, there's a lot of things in life we come across, you know, where we have to make decisions on our own, not what we believe in. They may or may not contradict what other individuals in the Libertarian Party is for. That's one of the great things about the Libertarian Party. We do not expect everyone to be brainwashed into our beliefs, you know. Like the other parties, you know, they'll really bully you into believing what they believe, you know. Hey, you're a Democrat, you must believe like we do. Hey, you're a Republican, you must believe like we do. You must believe this. No, that's not the case, you know. So they do add that to it. That song that you guys just heard, you know, that does kind of line right up into what we're about to talk to, which is get more detail about, which is personal liberty, which is number one on the Libertarian platform. The Libertarian Party is against government censorship. and there are people who would want that song censored, of course. Personal liberty, like I said before, the Libertarian Party is the only party that is for 100% personal liberty. And what these include, and that means individuals are free to make any choices they want as long as you're not taking away other people's life, liberty, or pursuit of happiness. We're against slavery. We're against killing people, innocent people outside of self-defense. And we are even for the freedom of
offending people. You have the right to offend people, all right? Our support of individual rights does not mean we support people's choices. And that's very important to note, because that seems to be one of the big problems, is the fact that, you know, people want government to regulate things because they personally are against it. And that's not the way it should be. As long as the other person's not forcing their belief on you, then why not let them live the life they want? As long as, I mean, if they're hurting themselves, they hurt themselves. That doesn't mean they can't go up to a friend and you know, coach them or something, you know, say, hey, listen, what you're doing is hurting you or your family, you know, and you really shouldn't be doing that. That's okay. But you shouldn't use government to force that on other people.
We missed probably about 5 seconds of your speech there.
Oh, no! what 5 seconds was it?
I don't know, but you didn't have it scripted, so. That is good. You know that's one of the things that, you know, a long time ago, before Obama was in office, I was having a discussion one time, telling him what my beliefs were. You know, and at that time, you know, I thought I was Republican and stuff. And he goes, "Why don't you check out the? Why don't you go read the Libertarian platform?" So I got online and I went and read the Libertarian platform. And I was like, oh, wow, I like this. And then I compared it to the Republican platform. And I was like, oh, God. And so that's where I started. And that's when I started my Libertarian Libertarian view. And got involved with the Libertarian. I vote Libertarian, and that's where I started. Someone just told me to go read the Libertarian platform, and he personally wasn't Libertarian. He was Republican. But he told me about the Libertarian Party. At that time, I knew nothing about them. So I switched over to Libertarian Party, and I started the Libertarian Party in my town. I'm the chairman. I'm the elected chairman in my town for the Libertarian Party. And it is. It's all about personal liberty and personal responsibility, individual rights. We don't believe government has a role in our lives as far as micromanaging from birth to death, and that's basically the way we are right now. They regulate us from birth to life, from birth to death. Let's take this for instance, okay? Why do you wear a seatbelt? Because it's law. You're told you have to. Now you might say today, you might say, well, because it saves my life. Well, while seatbelts could possibly save your life, the whole reason you're doing it is because you've been programmed to do it from the time you were born until the time you die to wear seatbelts, or you don't get a ticket. Now the original reason for it is because the federal government or the state governments, because it's not the federal law, it's state laws, states realize they can get people on it. They can make money off of it. You know, and they disguise it and they portray it as it's for your safety. And I'm gonna talk about a situation here that I did get in hot water over. I was driving an 18-wheeler from the oil field, and I had jumped in my truck and started, I was in the oil field, and I jumped in my truck and took off, and I didn't put my seatbelt on. And I got pulled over by a state trooper. He walks up, and he goes, "Well, you didn't have your seatbelt on." I said, "Yeah, I know. I forgot to put it on." Well, he goes, so he writes me a ticket. And this was over in Jasper, Texas. And so when he wrote me the ticket, I went to court. And me, I got a loud mouth. I'm very vocal about it, and I speak my mind.
No.
I don't care if you're the president of the United States. I'm gonna tell you like it is. Well, when I stand before the judge about it, you know, he told me, he goes, "Well, that's $200. And I said, "I don't want to pay the $200. He goes, "Why not?" I said, "Because I didn't elect you as my God. I didn't elect you as my God, and I didn't elect you as my parent. You're not my daddy, and you're not my mama." I said, "I didn't elect you to take care of me from my birth to my death." I said, I shouldn't have to put on a seatbelt if I don't want to put on a seatbelt." And he goes, "Well, it's state law." And I said, "I don't care about your state laws." I said, I have no respect for y'all to tell me what to do. I said, "I don't want to pay it." I said, "I'll pay it because I have to, because I need to get back to work." I said, "But I don't want to pay it. I shouldn't have to pay it because you're not my daddy and you're not my mama." And, which he got me for a contempt of court and added another $200 for a contempt of court on that for speaking out. And I told him that was a violation of my First Amendment rights. And my state constitution rights, because our state constitution allows us to freedom of speech. But anyways, I still paid the $400, but I felt a whole lot better that I was able to express my opinion about how stupid the seatbelt laws are, because it's not about safety; it's about income. And that's what it is. It's and that's what a lot of these laws are. Is income based. They're not, you know, they're not really for your safety. They're about the income. And that's one thing that is liberties. If I don't now you are supposed to put your kid. Now I do believe that. You should put your kids in a seatbelt until they're adults, until they're old enough to make their own decisions. As long as they're in the vehicle with you, they need to be seatbelted. But as an adult, do what you want to do. You shouldn't be forced to put seatbelts on yourself if you don't want to. And I'm just using seatbelts as one of the small laws that they like to put on us. Am I the only one here, or did everybody leave?
Joe left. He must have.
Joe went for a walk. Joe went for a walk. I guess his head exploded from how great he is. So, well, I don't have the point that he has pulled up, but the personal liberty is about you making your own decisions and. You know, you making the and you deal with the consequences of those decisions. Okay. If I don't put a seatbelt on and I have a wreck and I hurt myself because of and the injury that I had could have been prevented because of the seatbelt, that's my problem. I'm dealing with the consequences of it. I don't need you to write me a ticket on it. What do you think, Ms. Producer?
Yeah, I agree with that. I don't think there should be a law on seatbelt or... Because that's... If you're dumb enough to drive fast or not put your seatbelt on, then I guess that would be on you.
Yeah. And like I said, it's really, and there's a lot of laws like that. I think it was California that passed a law about I have to look it up, but I think they passed a law about tanning beds usage. Who cares?
Tanning bed.
Who cares if someone spends 70, 80 hours in a tanning bed? Leave them a freak alone. It's none of your business.
That's a weird law.
Yeah, let's talk about an old law, a really, really old law. I think it was in Kansas, Kansas, there's a law that you can't shoot a well from the second story building. In Kansas, what am I missing there? You can't shoot a well, you can't kill a well from a second story building in Kansas. Where? I'd like to see you come up with that law. It's just a lot of stupid laws that they passed it's basically for income, because everybody does it. There's a lot of people who do tanning beds, so they pass a law because they can make these people pay extra money to use tanning beds. And it's not just that. It's other laws such as, like we talked about, the seatbelt laws. You know, Texas, there's one law in Texas that I think you're not allowed to drink more than 3 sips of a beer while standing up. You know, I'll drink how many beers I want to drink whenever I want, you know. And it's just like little stupid laws like that, car registration. Why do I have to register my freaking car every year? There should, you know, I should be able to choose if I want to register my car or not. If I buy a car, I can go down it. Which I understand why you should register it, because if I buy a car and I go through a toll zone and I didn't register the vehicle, then they'll send the toll bill or the ticket to the person that it wasn't registered to, or that it was registered to before me. But I shouldn't have to be forced to do stuff like that. I should, you know. And that's a lot of the stuff. While I understand the registration part, but the inspection part, inspection vehicles. Well, we can go through a long list of situations that I don't find that there's a need for, unless it's just strictly for revenue. What do you think about personal liberty? Because apparently, is he back?
He's back.
About time.
Yeah, New Mexico, I guess, it doesn't like T-Mobile or AT&T. I lost signal on both phones.
I thought it was just me and the producer there. You got quiet.
and I was somewhere else, you know, sleeping or something.
Sleeping or something? What?
Wow.
I know. She said that right on her. Hey, we need to edit that out.
Only because I work late.
No. It's because Oklahoma Tomcat popped an unscheduled show on us.
yeah. Hey, we're talking about the registering the cars. I've brought that up to people before. And I say there's a root problem, a deeper problem with that whole thing. We got into that situation because we made it to where the government owns the roads. And, of course, you know, just like, you know, you have a say on whatever happens on your property, you know, what can be brought on your property and all that stuff, you know. That's how the government gets away with the registering the vehicles, is the fact that if you drive on their property, which they claim the ownership of the roads, which that was a huge mistake in the first place, then...
You should have never brought that up, because that brings a whole new can of worms right there. Property.
Yeah.
Let me tell you about property, okay? Let's say you go fishing on your property, okay? You can get a ticket if you don't have a fishing license. Let's say you go hunting on your property, okay? If you go hunting out of season, okay? Let's say I'm on my property and a deer walks across my property, and I say, hey, you know what? I'm hungry for some deer meat. Boom! I shot it, but I shot the deer out of season. You know, game warden. Here it is. The game warden can come into your house without a warrant. This is how a lot of people are getting, this is how a lot of states are doing stuff as well. Because let's say you're selling drugs, okay? Let's say you're manufacturing drugs. Let's say you're growing weed, okay? Now, you're doing all this stuff. You're growing weed, okay? The government can't prove you're growing weed, and they can't get a legal warrant to come into your house. All right, they can use a game warden to come into your house looking for game. Now he can't and whatever's out in the open, He can nail you for it, because the game warden has the same authority as a police officer. All right?
Yeah.
So I question this. How can a game warden enter into your house without a warrant?
And legally, he's not supposed to.
No. This is what they're talking about. Constitutionally, they're not supposed to. But you know how they got around it? Can you tell me how they got around it?
Nah. I didn't even know they could.
Yeah, game wardens can enter your house without a warrant because they have declared all animals, wildlife, all wildlife belongs to the state. So if an animal crosses your property, that means state property is on your property, and therefore the game warden can come in on your property to check to see if you have any illegal game, because all wildlife is the property of the state.
Yep.
Just like you said, the roads are the property of the state, the federal government, so they can tell you what you can and can't do on their property.
Yeah. Yep. Well, when we come back, we're going to go down this list of the personal liberty, because there is something on this list where personally Travis and I do disagree with. And we're going to use that to illustrate how the Libertarian Party welcomes all people, no matter what your personal belief is. Because this is the part that really attracted me to the Libertarian Party. I used to be Republican. I switched over to Libertarian thanks to three people in my life. One of them is my wife. She helped me see that I was actually Libertarian, because I was Libertarian before I switched. And another one is Travis, who is sitting here right here, who's my co-host. He also helped me realize that I was actually a libertarian in my beliefs. And as, believe it or not, as a an atheist who was a good friend of mine, he also helped me see, because we agreed politically, we just disagreed with our religious beliefs. He helped me see that I was also a libertarian, and told me, he was one that really pushed me to say, hey, take a look into it, because what you're talking about is libertarian. Well, you're going against your own party if you're a Republican. And sure enough, I was. But I really use the fact that there are things in my personal life where I disagree with that people do, but hey, we need to let people live their own life, and we should not force our beliefs onto others. Let's go ahead and take a break.
Hi, I'm Eric, a student at Hillsdale College. Here is President of Hillsdale College, Dr. Larry Arn, on natural rights versus entitlements.
America was founded on the idea that human beings are born with natural rights, such as the rights to life, liberty, and property. A person who holds this view of rights makes no demands on others except that they respect those rights. Today, however, many Americans talk about rights to a college education, state-of-the-art medical care, and even birth control pills. These are rights understood as entitlements, and a person who holds this view of rights, far from making no demands on other people, is making claims on other people's money and resources. This understanding of rights not only sets citizens against each other, but it undermines the whole idea of natural rights.
This Constitution Minute was brought to you by Hillsdale College. To receive a free pocket Constitution and Declaration, go to constitutionminute.com.
Last night, we put on an epic light show!
Yeah, we did!
The crowd loved us! We love the crowd!
Wait, but there were only four people out there.
Yeah, but did you see their four faces? All eight of their eyes lit up brighter than ours! And we're fireflies!
Yeah, we are!
Hey, that one girl, she looked like she'd never seen glow-in-the-dark like this before, and we invented glow-in-the-dark!
Yeah, we invented it!
And we're gonna be out here every night, rocking out our light show at a forest near you!
Woohoo!
So come check us out!
Check us out!
And bring your kid, all ages show. Oh, but don't bring any of those glass jars, because they make us kind of nervous.
Yeah, and I'm super claustrophobic.
Whether you're rocking their world or they're rocking yours, some memories never fade. Come alive with the forest. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you. And discover other cool things to do when you go, like fishing, biking, or even camping. Visit discovertheforest.org.
See you later!
Yeah, see you soon!
Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
Now we return to Political TNT with Travis Pope and the Oklahoma Tomcat. If you want to join in the conversation, dial 914-338-1906 and our lovely producer will get you on our show.
Be our lovely producer. That should not be our lovely producer. That should be our not so lovely producer, but very smart. And by the way, you cannot call in on this show. This is a pre-recorded show, and that's also why we're kind of changing up the format a little bit. Normally, right now, we'd be talking about a trucking issue. Our trucking section is usually centered around a current event that's going on. And because it's a pre-recorded show, we don't know when it's going to air. And things change so quick in the trucking industry, I figure we just go ahead and continue with our promotion of the Libertarian Party. And, Travis, I'd like to go down this list of personal liberty, which is the big one that the Libertarian Party is for. And... go over our personal feelings and what the Libertarian Party stands for and what we stand for both personally and in the society, because there is one part in here where personally I'm against this, but I do believe in the freedom of other people. Hey, do it if you want, you know. The first one is freedom of expression and communication. This is a big one now because we hear so much of people wanting to restrict what people say and what people do. well, one big one is you can't be against someone's personal relationship, for instance. You know, if you speak out against certain groups of people, then you are, you know, you get nailed for it. And the Libertarian Party is totally against that. You should be able to say whatever you want, anything you want. Words don't kill, so, you know. And you should be able to express anything you want as long as you're not taking away people's liberty, life liberty, or the pursuit of happiness. Anything you want to elaborate on that, sir, Trevor?
That's a big issue too, because while a lot of these laws that people have forgotten about is I'm gonna say it. Many of the churches and faith-based beliefs, they are against homosexuality. Okay. Oh, there you go. I said it. They are against homosexuality. Especially made a lot of it in the Christian religion. Now, the federal government has passed laws and signed them into law, the hate speech laws. I don't know if you remember any of them, because they kind of just fell by the wayside out of people's minds. Me, I don't forget things. So we're looking at areas like... And they were targeting pastors over this that would preach against homosexuality in the pulpit, and that was considered hate speech. And you could be prosecuted under federal law of hate speech if you spoke out against homosexuality in the pulpit. Do you remember those?
Yep, I remember all that. Yep.
And the reason why, and their deal is if you're preaching against homosexuality in the pulpit, and someone takes that to the extreme, because remember back then, whenever they passed them laws, there was a lot of gay bashing going on, physical, actual gay bashing, and they were trying to narrow it down to where it was coming from, and they said it must be coming from the pulpits. So if you're out there and you speak out of the Bible, and you show in the Bible where homosexuality is wrong, and someone in your congregation goes out and beats up a homosexual individual, then they could come after you for the hate speech.
Yep, and see, this is an important thing, because this is something I do talk about a lot, especially with the freedom of speech thing, because I am for total freedom of speech. Say whatever you want. In fact, I want you to, okay? When people speak out against Christians, I welcome it. Yeah, go ahead and speak your hate towards me because I'm a Christian. Go ahead, please do, because I want to know how you feel. Because that's good. You know, one of those things, you know, that you have to worry about. You don't have to worry about someone who expresses hate towards you or speaks against your beliefs or anything. You don't have to worry about that person, because that person has exposed themselves, and therefore you know where they stand. Do you know who you really have to worry about? The person who will not tell you how they feel about you. Those are the people you got to worry about. And what's funny is that's what the government wants, is for people to be silent. Just because someone doesn't speak out against you doesn't mean that they love you. All right? Those are the people you have to worry about, because you don't know where they stand. Those are the people that can stab you in the back. You wouldn't even know it. You know?
Yeah, you don't know. You don't know if they love you, like you, agree with you, or disagree with you.
Yeah,
you know,
exactly. And this even goes with businesses. I want to know which businesses hate Christians. I want to know it. I want to know which businesses hate white people or Indians or whatever other mixture I am. I want to know that, you know. And even though I may disagree with the fact that they may lock the doors on certain groups of people, I welcome that, you know, because let me tell you something. The government may be able to force someone to serve you, but they can't stop what happens in that kitchen, if you know what I mean. You know, they can't stop it. You know, the government can make you feel safe, but they cannot stop any violence, that towards you. They can't stop it. They can't stop somebody from hating you. So, you know, I'd want to know what businesses don't want to serve me. I want to know before I enter that door. If I enter a door and someone says, we hate people with beards, we're not going to serve you because you have a beard, I'll smile, I'll say thank you very much for letting me know that, and I'll walk out that door and I'll grab my phone and I'll say, hey, all my friends have beards, don't go to this restaurant. You know?
my uncle told me a story where he went to a church, I think it's the Church of the Nazarene, and I think that's the denomination, the Church of the Nazarene. But he went back whenever he was still in his hippie days. He had long hair, beard, and all that stuff, and he went to this church, and they told him he couldn't. They don't believe in long hair. A man should be clean cut and shaved and all that, and that he was sinning by having long hair and a beard. So he left the church. He didn't make a big fuss of it.
Right.
And I told when he told me that, because see, I study the Bible. I'm ordained in the Assemblies of God, and I've studied the Bible, and it's funny because when he told me, I said, "And what church was this?" And he said, "Church of the Nazarene." I said, "Do they not know what the Nazarene oath is, where the Nazarite oath, that's what it's called, the Nazarite oath in the Bible, is basically where you're not supposed to cut your hair or your beard or anything. What's his name? They just come out with a movie about him too. I just had a brain fart. He killed all the Philistines and Samson.
They made a movie about that.
Samson, he was a Nazarite from birth. No razor or no knife has ever touched a hair on his head. And that's what a Nazarite is. The Lord was a Nazarite from birth. No razor or knife has ever cut his hair. So it's funny that the Church of the Nazarene rejected my uncle for having a beard and long hair, hippie style, because of that. Because I was like, do they even know their own doctrine, what a Nazarite is?
Yeah.
But he didn't make a big fuss of it, and he just left. And like you're saying, if a place doesn't want you to have a hair, you walk in, we don't serve people with beards here or long hair. All right, I'll just leave. I'll go next door. And that's one thing I agree with as well as far in the Libertarian Party. Now, as a business owner myself, I will serve any race, creed, because, you know, I'm not looking at race, I'm looking at them greenbacks that you don't be bringing.
Yeah, same with me. I don't care. I'd serve anyone. Now, the one thing, now, like, the, for instance, for, I'll go ahead and step in this section here with the bake shop. Now, the bake shop was willing, was going to sell a cake to the homosexual couple for their marriage. What they were refusing was to decorate it. And that's there is where I agree with the bake shop. I wouldn't do it either, because I would look at that as I'm condoning through my actions the thing that I am, the lifestyle that I am against. You know, same thing with the photographer. You know, he would not take pictures of the homosexual wedding because of the fact that he feels that by being there and doing that, he would be supporting it. That there is where I would also draw a line as a business owner. I would serve anyone, but I would not do any action that would show that I would be condoning what they're doing is correct. And that there, the Libertarian Party says, that is the right of the business, of the private business owner. You know, that's where the distinction has to be, you know, because it's not being run by the government.
We're talking about some small issue like this, okay? Now let's go all the way to the town of Vidor, Texas, okay? Vidor, Texas. I don't know if you've ever heard about it, but Vidor, Texas is considered one of the most racist towns in the United States. Matter of fact, they used to have a sign up when you entered into Vidor. There used to be a sign when you come into Vidor. Don't let the sun go down on your black ass. Okay, that's what the sign said. A person of color would not be serviced anywhere in the town of Vidor at one time. Matter of fact, it wasn't until just recently that the federal government put pressure on them and took their funding away that they actually built low-income housing to start having racial diversity into the town. And until then, there was no black people, there was no Mexican, there was no Chinese, no nothing. It was an all white town, Vidor, Texas. Okay? I don't, you know what? That's their issue. That's their problem. And as a libertarian, more power to them, I guess. Would I stop there? I probably would if I needed gas in my vehicle, but I probably would have bought gas back in Beaumont, Texas, before I got to Vidor, Texas, because to this day I have never to this day, knowing about Vidor, Texas, I have never shopped in that town.
Yeah.
Never. I have never spent a dime, a penny, in Vidor, Texas. Because of their stance,
mm-hmm.
you know, and they still, and a lot of them still believe that, and a lot of them still do it. Now the government of the Vidor, Texas, the only reason why they changed is because the federal government come in and took their funding away. Now they say, well, we need to get our funding back so we can build roads and stuff, and that's what they've been doing, is building roads through there now. So they went ahead and started doing what the federal government told them, so they can get their money to fix the roads through Vidor, Texas.
Yeah, they're bribed into acting like they are okay with diversity, with different types of people being in their town, but that bribery make the people start loving people of different races.
It didn't change their actual view.
Yeah.
It just changed the way they had to deal with people.
So basically the federal government promoted people being fake.
Yeah. And I don't know if you ever knew that. I mean, you can look it up.
Yeah, I did. In fact, you brought that up to me many years ago, and I looked it up back then. That's exactly, you know, one of my biggest pushes for, you know, allow people to say what they want to say, allow people to act, as long as they're, like I said, as long as they're not physically harming people, let them show their expression, let them expose themselves, stop promoting fake people. Fake people are dangerous. All right, let's kind of hit on this next one, which is another big one in today's world, is privacy. The Libertarian Party is 100% for you having your personal privacy. and for government not to be spying on us or seeking information from us. And this even includes with emails, medical records, phone records, all this stuff. The Libertarian Party is totally against that, and there's not much for me to elaborate on that. I am 100% against that. I'm even against the income tax because you have to give up your personal privacy on that, you know, to file for your taxes.
I'm against the census.
Against what?
The census.
Oh, yeah, yep, I'm against that too. Yep.
You know,
oh, my wife goes crazy on that. she tells me to deal with them because when they come to our house because she'll go off on them.
Yeah, because you got to fill out that census, what, every 10 years?
Yep. Which is funny, we fill it out. I go ahead and fill it out and everything and send in just because, you know, well, I don't feel like going to jail over it. But they still come to my property and ask me questions. I'm like, I filled that out. Why are you guys here?
Yeah. And by law, you have to fill it out. I'm like, why?
Yeah, no. Yep. Yeah, and Libertarian Party is totally against all that stuff. You should not have to give up your privacy for the government. There is no reason why we should have to do that.
Which, by the way, the census is probably coming up pretty soon anyways.
Yeah, that I'm going to hear from my wife if I'm on the road when they show up. I'll probably have to be off the air for a while because I'll be bailing her out of jail.
When was the last census? In 2008?
I think so. I never remember when they are. Now here's one where there is a little bit of this one here, this next one I'm going to bring up, is a great example of how the Libertarian Party welcomes all people, no matter what your personal feelings and belief is, personal relationships. Okay, we kind of touched on this before. The Libertarian Party believes that as long as the two is consenting, that you have the two people, three people, whatever, consents to the relationship, go at it. You know, the government should not be involved. The government should not even license it, which I'm 100% for that, and I'm so glad Oklahoma got rid of the marriage license. Because, you know, my thought is, who gave government the power to decide what marriage is? You know, to me, that only belongs to God, you know. And the government is not my God. So I pushed for that Oklahoma to get rid of the marriage license. But, you know, it's still not far enough because the federal government asks if my wife and I are married, you know. The only good thing is the fact that in Oklahoma, if you say you're married, you're married. This is a great example of how flexible the Libertarian Party is with this stuff. You know, they don't push you to believe everything that, you know, the higher-ups believe. I personally am against homosexual relationships. I'm against it. It goes against my Christian beliefs. But that doesn't mean that I'm going to say that the government should step in and stop some two guys or two females from getting married. They can get married all they want. Now, don't force me to accept that. Don't force me to condone it. Don't force me to say, hey, good job, yay. No, because I won't. What I'll say is, that's a sin. All right? But go at it. You're not hurting me. You're not physically hurting anyone. So go at it. What's your thoughts there?
No, I agree with it. I agree. You know, I don't care what you do. Just leave me alone.
Exactly.
I don't agree with. Don't ask me to come there. Don't ask me to be your best man. Don't, or anything like that. I don't condone it. I don't agree with it. But what you do in the privacy of your own room, I don't. Or in the privacy of your own house, I don't care. Leave me alone.
Yep. Yeah. So, yeah. And that even goes to, you know, that even goes to, you know, your business or anything else. I mean, as long as you're not making me feel uncomfortable when I go in your business, you know, hey, if two guys own a business, I'll still shop there, I'll still do business there, and, you know, even when it comes to our elected officials, hey, I don't mind that you're married to another guy, you know, my thing is, I'm not electing you to be my pastor, I'm electing you to uphold the Constitution and uphold the laws. You know,
yeah, and you know, I got when I was running my construction business down there, I was running a home remodeling business. I was called out one time to a house, to do a bid on a flooring job, and the guy made it perfectly clear that he was gay and he was married to another guy multiple times. He was pushing it, and, you know, and I looked at him, okay, I don't know why you keep telling me that, but I don't care, you know, I'm just looking at your floor, I want the money, I'm not going to sit here and say, well, I'm not going to do business with you because you're gay, I just want your money, you know, because it was turned out to be almost a $10,000 job, and so I'm not that he needed a new floor. So I'm not sitting there looking at the situation as, you're gay, I'm not going to come in here and do your floor for you. I'm sitting there looking at, hey, here's a fellow customer, I want your money. You know, you got a pretty bad project right here. You got about $10,000 worth of work that needs to be done. Give me that money, you know. I don't care. You know, I don't care what you are, and frankly, I wish you would have just shut up about you and your husband, because I don't need to know how many times, I don't need you to repeat yourself 100 times, okay, I get it, the first time you told me, you're gay, all right, that's fine, and the next 20 times after that, I really don't care.
Yeah, and that's where it really does make it more difficult is when you have someone that pushes their relationship. Even after, you know, you've shown that you, hey, listen, you know, your relationship is your business, you know.
And I gave him the bid, and he didn't accept my bid. But the thing was is that I had the feeling that he was trying to fake me. Fake me into saying, well, I'm not going to do business with you. I'm not going it was like he was trying to fake me into saying, well, I'm not going to do business with you because you're gay. You know, that ain't going to happen because, which if I said it, I probably would have got a bunch of publicity out of it because not all bad publicity is bad publicity, you know, because
you're right.
Like for instance, Chick-fil-A come out and said that they were against gay marriage. And you've seen how that backfired whenever the liberals come out with their, let's boycott them, man. They made more money in those few days.
Yeah, they did.
Than
they
made their,
and that's they, because they, they, yeah, so, and that's because they did follow, like, what the libertarians believe, which is, you know, yeah, we're personally against it, but, hey, we still serve them. In fact, when that that club got shot up and people were out there helping them, Chick-fil-A actually catered to it, you know. So we're running out of time, and unfortunately we didn't hit on everything, but please check out the Libertarian platform. You can go to lp.org to check them out. We only touch on just a fraction of what libertarians are for. We are for true freedom, not full security. That's the key thing. You can check us out online, ptat.show. We will See what our times are. We're on Mondays, Wednesdays, Sundays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Y'all have a great day. And do you guys have any last words?
Chick-a-boom, chick-a-boom. Yeah, y'all take it easy, and we'll see y'all on one of our live shows.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Good night, John boy.
I came to Planned Parenthood seeking women's healthcare services.
I came to Planned Parenthood for birth control.
They made a priority to make sure that I knew all of the information and that I felt comfortable.
Because the atmosphere here is one of acceptance and understanding and health.
Why would I go anywhere else?
We are Planned Parenthood Southwest Ohio, the region's most trusted reproductive health care provider. Go to ppswo.org to find the health center nearest you.
Hi, it's Jamie, Progressive's Employee of the Month, 2 months in a row. Leave a message at the... Hi, Jamie. It's me, Jamie. I just had a new idea for our song about the Name Your Price tool. So when it's like, tell us what you want to pay, hey, 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 and the trombone goes, blah, 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 and you say, we'll help you find coverage options to fit your budget. Then we just all do finger snaps while a choir goes, savings coming at ya, savings coming at ya. Yes? No? Maybe? Anyway, see you at practice tonight. I got new lyrics for the rap break.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Price and coverage match limited by state law.